Hi, my name is Vanshika Janeja. I cleared my CA finals in May 23 attempt by scoring exemption in FR. And this was my third attempt. I gave the earlier two attempts in May 22 and November 22 respectively, and was not able to clear the exams just because mainly of one subject, which is FR, as my scores were pretty bad. 33 and 34 in those. So, how did I score 61 from 33 in just 3 months? I'm here to share my tips and tricks with you. Number one tip I would say is maintaining a speed. As you all know, FR is the most lengthy exam, and even the syllabus is quite big to cover, and like you are going to take like 4 or 5 days to cover the syllabus, right, before exams. So how to maintain speed is the main question. For speed, you need a written practice, as much written practice as possible. So even if you are doing questions and you are just too tired and you know that ye wala question ho hi jayega, don't just solve on the calculator, but keep pages near you and solve it roughly, just so that you understand what you have written. But it helps you maintain a speed help. And it's not only in FR exam, but also in theory exams like audit and law. I used to write every answer so that I can have better speed in the actual exam. So yeah, speed is very necessary, because if you're not able to cover like 80 to 90% of the question paper, or you're not able to write 80 to 90% of the answers, how are you gonna pass? It's hard to pass otherwise. So the second point is need for perfection. What I used to do was I used to think step marking hai toh. So what happened was, in question number one, even though I did not know how to solve the big and the main adjustments, I used to make notes of the items of balance sheet that doesn't really have much adjustments, like say for trade receivables or inventories or cash. And making those unnecessary notes really took my time, slowed me down, and it didn't really give me much of marks either. So in case you find some items of balance sheet that doesn't have adjustment, just simply make a bracket, write the amounts, and make the total in the amount column, so that you have to understand that you have to finish your answers in the given period of time, that is 3 hours. So don't waste your time on unnecessary things, right? Point number third is second guessing myself in exams. So what do I mean by second guessing? Is when I used to write an answer, and I saw the whole answer completely, and I started thinking, maybe I did something wrong, or maybe it's supposed to happen in some other way, and maybe I wrote this amount wrong and I should have written that amount too. And that second guessing will decrease your speed a lot, and you won't be able to move on to the next question, right? At the back of your mind, you will still be thinking about the earlier question. Maybe, I did not do that right, or like that. So what you have to do in exam is read the question, attempt the answer, and even if you're not sure of it, you have to move on. You have to complete the exam. You can't get stuck at one answer only, right? It's you can't pass by attempting few questions in the perfect manner possible, but you will pass by attempting the most, the 80 90% of the answers in average manner. That's how you're gonna pass. You can't pass by simply writing two answers perfectly. You can't get marks for that. How much you can't even reach to 40's by attempting two questions perfectly. So don't go for perfection, go for completion. And point number four is not fixing what question to do first or which question to leave. So this was a trick my senior told me. So what you have to do is, in the 15 minutes you get, which you get to read the question paper, you have to give a bird's eye view to every question. You have to make a sequence, for example, like 3, 4, 1, 5, 6, how you're gonna solve the question, depending on which question you have the, you have the confidence that you can do better, do it first. And that's how you make a sequence, and you have to stick to that sequence. So you have to make that sequence and just stick to it, and make sure you have decided beforehand which question you're gonna leave first. And for me, it was decided even before the exam paper, even before I get the exam paper in hand, because in all the analysis I do of the past exam paper, I came to realize that question number 2 was the trickiest of all. So I made up my mind that I'll leave question number 2 unless and until there's some other question that I'll be totally blank about. So yeah, it was decided. And next point is taking too much of the stress. See, I know it feels depressing sitting in the four walls day in, day out, studying, and it gets depressing. You might get existence crisis at some point, and it's normal. It's normal to feel that way. It's normal to feel low and thinking that why you are not able to clear it yet. It's completely normal to feel that way. You are human. My advice for that would be, you have to take breaks. You have to learn to take breaks weekly or daily basis. So whenever you finish the revision of one subject, let's say you decided that you will take 5 days for revising audit, the first revision. Then after 5 days, on the 6th day, take a day off, go out, have fun. Just chill and don't think about exams that day. So the 7th day, when you get back, you will be serious and there'll be less stress. So I used to play with my friends in the neighborhood, and it used to keep stress away. So it really helped me. And that's enough tips, but I would like to share something else with you, which really helped me. But it's not necessary that you have to do that. Just something I did to understand why I am not getting the marks, right? So I signed up for a test series and they conducted like two full syllabus tests per subject. So I was giving only the group 1 in May 23, as I cleared group 2 in November 22 only. So 2 full syllabus tests for every subject. And so the ICSI center in the city where I live, they were not conducting mock tests because there weren't much inquiry about that. So what I used to do was, I used to download the mock test paper, I used to solve it, and by the next day when the suggested key comes in, I used to take the printout of the suggested key and I used to take my answer sheet to my neighbor. She had the basic knowledge of accounting. She had the basic knowledge, but not as much as was required for the CAs and checking paper. And I used to ask her if you can check paper so that I understand what a person with a suggested key and my answer is looking for. Because I was not able to understand why I was not getting the marks. It's a different thing that you know the answer in your mind, and it's another thing to communicate the very same answer in your answer sheet so that the checker understands what you are wanting to write, right? So I used to ask her, so please check my answer sheet and tell me how I can improve. So it helped me understand what to write and how to write, and it really did help in my exam. So that was all, and I hope this video helped you. And if it does, I'll be happy to hear that I could be of any help to you. Thank you.